Every now and then, big brands are trying to put on the market a different type of shoe, and this one for sure is one of them. Hello guys, and welcome back to a brand new review. In today's video, we're gonna have a look at this not so usual pair of shoes. So let's go ahead and take them out of the box. Okay guys, so I give you the Reebok Zig 3D Storm Hydro. So this futuristic shoe was actually released in UK just a few months back for a retail price of £150, which, coming from Reebok, in my opinion feels a bit too much, and I think they were just relying that this one really feels a bit more futuristic than all of the shoes that are out there at the moment. And if you own any of the Zig 3D shoes which they were released before this one, you realize that this one is actually very, very different. I actually own a pair of Zig 3D Storm, which I actually have it here, but as you can see, these two are two totally different shoes, and I'm not entirely sure why they decided to keep the same name when they are so different. So let's go ahead and see what materials we have on this Back to the Future shoe. As you can see, we have a lot of material. We have a lot of rubberized material as well. We also have some mesh, so I would think that this shoe is quite breathable. So as you can see, starting here at the toe section, we have this rubberized material which covers all toes, and on top of it we have this rubber material which actually has also a hook for the lacing system. And then as we go to the lacing system, which is hidden underneath this rubber cover, you can see that we have on both sides some mesh material in this gray color. So as you can see, on this side actually we have two different types of mesh. And as you can see, on top of this mesh, we also have this rubberized overlay. Also here at the back, you can see that we have yet again another type of mesh in this green color. And here at the top, a totally different mesh again. So overall, I think we have four types of mesh used on this shoe. So the green one here at the top will actually go all the way to the other side, and it will cover all side here. Then we're gonna go to this very interesting lacing system, which has these infinity laces, which you can actually also tighten with this system. As you can see, this one is actually a very flexible one. So underneath we have the lacing system. But this lacing system, it's actually covered by this rubber material in this gray color, which is actually called Shelter Shield, as you can see written here on top of it. And this system works like this. You just tighten your shoelaces, you then use this hook to keep it in place. And then you will just use the second hook, which is here at the back, and put in place this rubberized material. But I would say that if you have skinny feet and you really need to tighten up these shoelaces, this hook will be actually useless, as this one will hang like this. Also under this lacing system we have this very short tongue, which is actually not that padded, but I should say that in my case, because I have skinny feet, this actually doesn't work too good, as inside having skinny feet I have a lot of room, so I don't actually feel that I'm actually filling up this shoe properly. So I guess I will actually need to put an extra insole. Inside, I could say that here at the ankle section, the padding is very good. I actually wish that this padding could be the same here in the thong section, as this one is quite thin. As you can see, this lining is in this cream color. And then as we go to this heel section, you can see that we have this material, which you have it at the front as well. So I guess this one will act like a mud guard. As you can see, we have it throughout all of this shoe. So this mud guard also has the Reebok logo here at the back. And just above it, we have this rubber material, which has also the hook and also the red logo again. And just underneath this rubber material, we have this pull tab, which also has some reflective 3M on it. I actually saw that we have few points of this reflective throughout all of the shoes. So for sure, this will be in handy at night. Then we're gonna go to this very interesting looking midsole, which starts with this part here at the top in this gray color. So for me, this one really feels like a plastic PPU casing, so I guess this one actually acts like a support for the actual shoe. And just underneath we have this foam midsole in this black color with this very strange holes in it. But I really felt that this one is actually quite comfortable, and I think it's just because under this covers we actually have inside the float ride energy, which in my opinion is just another name for the boost technology. As you can see here, we have an exposed material, which if you look very close, it's really looking very, very similar to the Boost technology. I might be mistaking, but for sure that now Reebok is owned by Adidas. For sure they are trying to put their technology in Reebok as well. Then we're gonna finish with this rubber outsole in this black color, which has a very interesting pattern, as you can see here. And overall, I really need to admit that this shoe really looks interesting. I was actually quite impressed when I actually saw the pictures online a few months back. As in for the actual sizing, I felt that this one is actually true to size. But in my case, as I have skinny feet, I really felt that I'm not actually filling up the shoe properly. I really feel that I have a lot of space inside. Had to put an extra insole inside just to fill up the shoe properly. But rather than that, I feel that this shoe is actually comfortable. But it's not something that I would wear every day for sure. This one actually feels like a low boot, if I can say so, but it's a comfortable one. The materials are actually quite interesting. The support here at the ankle section is actually a very good one. But yeah, I really need to admit that this looks very futuristic for sure. It doesn't look like your usual shoes that you wear every day. So yeah guys, this was the unboxing and reviewing of this Reebok Zig 3D Storm Hydro, which indeed it's a very long name. Also, I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to press the like button, maybe also subscribe to the channel, and as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching.